Okay.
My name is Avery, I'm a sophomore.
My name's Antonio, I'm a senior.
My name's Kimber, I'm a sophomore.
And my name is Simon, and I'm a senior, and we're from Lake Eric.
And this is our poem, How to Have an Existential Crisis.
Welcome to
Hiding in Extra. Can someone spell this
out? Anyone?
Existential? E-I. Y. S-I-S. Welcome to Having an Existential Crisis. You spell that simple.
Recognize your surroundings. Your entire universe
is changed. Recognize your view.
And slowly you are being consumed wholly. By the
Milky Way, by the millions of galaxies in this universe, the total billions of suns or planets orbiting each of them, you don't quite know how you got here.
Or why you are
here? Or what living really means. Remember, you are made of the same molecules that shape stars. The fabric of the universe is stitched in you.
You are completely missing every 7 years. Hundreds and thousands of cells die in replacing each other. You hear your heart beating.
The feeling of air in your lungs. Your body is appearing distant from your mind.
On the verge of existential crisis, you realize your size. The relativity of each breath you take
pouring into
biolistic despair.
You may be having an existential crisis because you dare to question how to follow the moon, like they are. And in the moment of all this rush, you just want everyone to slow down.
Okay, there's
no
better than inside
your heart, you
step when you walk in the
rain. One. What am I actually here for?
The rain falls as my
word does. I fall like the drops drown me on the cement. My arms extend upwards as if I'm defying the gods.
Why? Is
that why it rains? But I feel like I see more thunderstorms than spring rains.
Time speeds up yet, life is freezing you.
And the only way to describe the film is by breaking down and shedding the tears.
The overwhelming sense of agency pulled on puppet
film
and the feeling that you just can't do it.
It's towards the end that everything around you and in your mind slows down. Right?
Your heart is intended to start to beat the stick of you because this is the sort of puppet you get every time you see her. But the time that
seems so hard,
you know that
this one
will be the last.
Your face isn't your own anymore. Arming itself from your nose down, and your hand there. And you're not entirely sure what they're doing because you thought movements like this only meant the leaves caught in the wind.
Your thoughts stop moving at lightning speed. Your heart rate slows down as well.
There's a sense of arrival. You don't know how, but it's something. No.